Okay, my dear students, today we are starting new chapter, kinematics. That means motion in one dimension. In other words, motion in a straight line. About that we are doing. So I think in lower classes, class 9, we used to learn the formulas. First formula was V is equal to U plus AT. S is equal to UT plus half AT square. Third formula was V square is equal to U square plus 2S. These three formulas you are quite familiar with in lower classes. What is V? V is final velocity, U is initial velocity, A is acceleration and T is time. S is distance or displacement. Because the motion in a straight line, the distance and displacement will be same. Rest of the things are known. V square is equal to U square plus 2S. These two formula may be new to you. This formula will apply. S is equal to V into T. This is only applicable for uniform straight line motion. Uniform motion where the acceleration is zero, that means velocity is constant. Initial final velocity is same. So that time we will be using the formula S is equal to VT. S means distance is equal to velocity into time, or uniform velocity into time you can say. Or you can say distance is equal to speed into time. And the last formula is quite new to you. This is called distance moved by the body in nth second of time. Nth means that particular second of time. Formula goes down like this: U plus half A 2A minus 1, where N is the nth second of time. Nth. So now we'll be proving this formula one by one. How to prove them? If the question comes to prove this formula, how do we prove? There are various methods. There is analytical method, there is a graphical method, there is a calculus method. So we'll be doing the easiest method, that is the analytical method. So let us see how do we prove these formulas one by one. Let us prove the first, this formula V is equal to U plus AT. How to prove it? Question may come: derive or prove V is equal to U plus AT. This one will be doing that is proof, or this one will do that is. We'll be writing the definition of acceleration. What is acceleration? The rate of change of velocity. And the SI unit of acceleration is meter per second square. So first we will be writing A is equal to change in velocity by time. Rate of change of velocity. Rate means dividing by time. The change in velocity by that time. Next line we write that is A is equal to change in velocity means V minus U upon T. We will do cross multiply. Then it will become V is equal to U plus AT. So this formula is proved. This formula we prove by the definition method. So this is simplest to prove this one. Now the second formula we are proving now. S is equal to UT plus half AT square. So to prove the second formula, we will be first writing this one. Average velocity formula we have, distance, displacement by the time, you will be writing as S by T. Therefore, S will be equal to average velocity into time, into T. That S, average velocity in terms of U and V will be taken as this, U plus V by 2, average of these two velocity, U plus V by 2, into T. Now, we will be writing S. As per the need, we'll be using the formula. The formula which we have to prove doesn't have V coming here. In the formula, V is not there. We will be substituting the value of V which we already derived. So that here U, put the value of V. The value of V is U plus AT. So we will put that value. U plus AT upon 2 and whatever is T. We can add them. This becomes like this. S is equal to 2u plus AT by 2 into T. We can separate it, will become as 2u by 2 plus AT by 2 into T. 2 to cancel, multiply, you get UT. This 1 by 2 keep aside, you get AT square. So proved. Second formula is proved. Quite simple, we'll be starting with this result and then we'll do it. Now, formula number 3, how do we prove? That is V square is equal to U square plus 2AS. So to prove this formula, again we'll be writing the same thing. You can write here since x is equal to average velocity into time. From here only we begin. These two steps are common rather. We'll be writing as s, average velocity, same we will do u plus v by 2 into t. These two steps are same. Now we'll be changing the subject of formula out here. The formula which you want to prove does not have t coming there. T is not there. So we'll be substituting the value of t. This t value will substitute. We'll be writing this s is equal to u plus v by 2. Put the value of t from here. The value of t will become v minus u by a. Let's write that. V minus u by a. You can make a note here. Since a is equal to v minus u by t, or t is equal to v minus u by a. The value of t is substituted. Now we do cross multiply, become entire thing become 2as. Or here we are using the formula a minus b and a plus b. It will become v square minus u square. U square will come this side. We can write as u square plus 2as. So third formula is also proved. Second formula and the third formula, steps are common steps are here. S is equal to u plus v by 2 into t. S is equal to u plus v by 2 into t. You can begin from these two results directly and then change the subject of formula. In this case, we don't have v coming there, so we'll put the value of v. And in this case, we don't have t coming in the formula. T doesn't come, so we'll put the value of t. And rest of the things are easy. You can prove it. Now we are proving the formula number 4, which is the easiest way to prove. Formula number 4. Now you can see how we can prove that formula number 4. That is s is equal to vt. How to prove it? So to prove, we'll be writing that since s is equal to ut plus half at square, which we already proved in the formula number 2. You can write here for uniform motion. For uniform motion, u and v will be equal because velocities are all same, constant. Initial velocity, final velocity will be the same. And a will be 0 because the formula of a is v minus u by t and v and u are equal. Let us put the value here, right? Therefore, s is equal to, instead of u, we can write v, or even we can write u, vt plus half into a is 0, t square. Answer will become vt. So this becomes the formula for uniform motion. Now the formula number 5 is a bit tricky. A bit technical. So to prove formula number 5, first you have to understand the concept of nth second. What is the meaning of nth second? Okay, take it this way. I am telling you two statements. Check whether the two statements are same or they are different. Distance moved by the body in 10th second of time and distance moved by the body in 10 second of time. Are the two statements same or they are different? I say these two statements are different. 10th second, when I say 10th, that means that particular second. That means the total duration is 1 second. Between 9 and 10 second, whatever is the distance traveled. Means after 9 second and just before 10 second, whatever distance is traveled, that is the distance covered by the body in 10th second of time. But 10 seconds of time, that means from beginning, total time is 10 seconds. So we can use a trick out here. Suppose I say from the point A the body moves and reaches the point B, the total time is 10 seconds here. 10 seconds. Total time for the body to reach the point B is 10 seconds. Now in 9 seconds the body is here. In the 9 seconds the body is here. The distance covered in 9 seconds is from beginning is over here. So what is the distance covered in the 10 seconds? I am sure this one. This is the distance covered in the body in 10 seconds. This will be the distance covered by the body in 10 seconds. That means to find the distance covered by the 10 seconds, we can do like this. The distance covered by the body in total 10 seconds of time minus distance covered by the body in 9 seconds of time. Then you will get the 10 second value. Similarly, how to find the distance covered by the body in 20th second, 20th second of time will take the full distance covered by the body in 20 seconds minus distance covered by the body in 19 seconds, one less than that second, 19 seconds we can do. Similarly, we can write here dn with distance moved by the body in ns second, we will be writing this sn minus sn minus 1. That means distance moved by the body in n second, means full n second, this total timing is n seconds, minus distance moved by the body in 1 less than that, n minus 1 seconds. That means full time is n second, and then n minus 1, that this particular time will get now nth second. So we can write now dn, formula of sn will be, formula of s is ut plus half a t squared. This is the distance covered by the body in t second of time. Now the distance covered by the body in n second of time, n second, that means we can write a un plus half a n squared minus, here we can write u bracket n minus 1 plus half a n minus 1 squared. Instead of time t, we are having a time n second, and out here time is n minus 1. So now we can expand and simplify, we will get the same answer as I have written in the formula. We get un plus half a n squared minus, let us expand it, you get un minus u plus half a, I'll expand this one using the formula a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. Once you open the bracket, un and un will cancel. Now minus minus plus u, we let us write first. Here we have half a n squared minus of this half a bracket n squared minus 2n plus 1. Now write u as it is, half a common, here we get n squared minus of this entire thing. So minus 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 is plus 2n, minus plus is minus 1. You can cancel these two, and the answer left over will be half a 2n minus 1. This is the formula of distance moved by the body in nth second of time, nth, nth. That means where dn is distance moved in nth second of time. So this is how we will derive the formula number 5. So all 5 formulas derivation we have done today. Okay. Now we will discuss about the motion of a body in a vertical plane like this, vertical plane going up or coming down. This formula which I have used or which I have proved was applicable for horizontal motion. The body is moving in a straight line path but horizontally like this. But what about when the body moves up or moves down? So that time let us see the formula. The same formula will slightly change. For vertical motion, first formula will be ready. V is equal to u minus gt will like here. Why minus sign? Because when the body goes up, it goes against the gravity, the value of A will become minus g, there will be retardation. So this is the formula for vertical motions. Same formula we can slightly change over. A will become g, but sign of A we will take positive or negative. Upward motion, when the body goes up, here I am marking the arrow, when the body goes up, the sign of A will become negative g. Sign of g, gravity will be negative because it's going against the gravity. Second formula, s is equal to ut plus half a t squared will change and become, instead of s we will be writing h, means height, vertical height, which is same as distance only, but vertical distance we call it height. Ut minus half gt squared will like it. A will become g, and with the minus sign because of upward motion we are taking. And the third formula will be writing v is equal to u squared minus 2gh. This is the way we slightly modify or we change the formula. V is equal to u minus gt, h is equal to u minus ut minus half gt squared, and v squared is equal to u squared minus 2gh. Beside that, we can take the vertically downward motion. So the formula will be same, but sign only will change. You get v is equal to u plus gt. Second formula will become ut plus half gt squared. And the third formula will be v squared is equal to u squared plus 2gh. sign will change, rest of the thing will remain the same. Fourth formula, S is equal to Vt, does not exist here because A is never constant and A is never 0. The value of G cannot be 0, so we cannot use the formula number 4. Fifth formula can be used here. We can write here distance moved by the body in d at time, distance moved by the body in the or height moved by the body in nth second of the time. When it goes up, we can write here u at same formula minus half a value will become minus g 2a minus 1. The same way we can write the formula. Instead of a, we will be writing minus g when it goes up. When it comes down, the value of a will become plus g, and rest of the thing will keep the same. Now another question, when the body goes up, that time when it reaches the maximum height, that time final velocity becomes 0. When the body is going up, the velocity is decreasing, it becomes 0, then the body returns back. So that time final velocity will be 0 when the body goes up. On the other hand, when the body is falling downward, that time u will be 0, initial velocity will be 0 when the body is falling down under gravity or free fall motion. Free fall motion time, the initial velocity is 0, the body yet comes down due to acceleration due to gravity. And question may come, can a body have a 0 velocity yet it has acceleration? Answer is yes. The body will have acceleration, still the velocity can be 0. So when the body is falling down under gravity, the initial velocity is 0, yet there is acceleration. Or here is the case, when the body is going up, when it reaches the maximum height, velocity becomes 0, but the g does not become 0, acceleration does not become 0. This also, there is a possibility of this case. Now, we are deriving some formulas, short formulas for the maximum height reached by a body. Or let us write time of rise. I will use the find the formula of time of rise. Time of rise, formula for the time of rise. So we will be writing the same formula, rise is going up, so we will first write v is equal to u minus gt, right, at maximum height, v will be 0, we will put the value 0, 0 is equal to u minus gt, gt will come this side, the gt is equal to u, therefore t will be equal to u by g. So this is the formula of time of rise. I write at t rise formula g upon g. We can either start from here and put the value v 0, or we can directly use the formula in case of problems, t rise is equal to u by g. Directly we can use this formula. Now, how to find maximum height? Expression or the formula for maximum height reached by the maximum height. To find maximum height reached by the body, we can use this formula. V square is equal to, let us start with this, since V square is equal to U square minus 2GH. At the time of maximum height, V will be 0. We will write here 0 square is equal to U square minus 2GH. 2GH will come this side, is equal to U square. Therefore, H value will become U square by 2G. So this is the formula of H max, maximum height. So, time of rise formula is u by g and maximum height formula is u squared by 2g. So, directly if we start from this formula v square, we start with this way, v square is equal to u square minus 2g and put in the value of v 0, then also it's okay. Or in case of problems, we can directly use h max is equal to u squared by 2g. So, direct formula for time of rise and for maximum height we are getting by this equation only. Putting the value of v, v value will put 0, final velocity value is 0 and then we get it. Okay, so today we are doing this much. Tomorrow we will be proving that the time of rise and time of fall are equal, and we will do some problems, and with that the chapter will be over. Thank you.